You deployed a workflow to KNIME Server and want to execute it? There are different options to choose from to run your workflow on the server, via KNIME Analytics Platform, via the KNIME Web Portal, via the Remote Workflow Editor, and via REST. To execute a workflow via KNIME Analytics Platform, we have to connect to the server. Whenever a workflow is executed on KNIME Server, a new job is created. This happens regardless of whether you trigger execution from KNIME Analytics Platform, the web portal, or REST. Jobs are children of their corresponding workflow and can be run on demand or scheduled. A job can have a different status, represented by different icons in the KNIME Explorer. Here are some examples. Scheduled jobs for single execution have an icon with a single clock. If a job is scheduled at regular intervals, it is marked by three clocks, which you can see here. A successfully executed job, indicated by the green circle, is one where all nodes have executed successfully. Currently executing jobs have three green horizontal arrows. An unsuccessfully executed workflow, where an error occurred during execution, has a red circle. By using the Remote Workflow Editor, or Show Workflow Messages, for a quick view, we can check what caused the error. The red circular arrow shows that the original workflow was overwritten and the job was executed using a previous version of the workflow. Let's now execute this deployed workflow. Right-click and select Execute to open the Execute dialog. Here are your execution and scheduling options. Reset before execution will fully reset the workflow before it is run on the server. If you want it to run in its executed state, as it was uploaded to the server, then uncheck this option. This is useful for debugging long-running jobs, where you don't want to always start the execution from the beginning. The option Discard Workflow Job After Execution will remove the job immediately after completion, without saving it. This is useful to conserve memory and disk space. If unchecked, the job will stay in memory for 1 hour and on disk for 7 hours after execution, per default. When a workflow runs successfully, you might want to let the relevant team members know, or even automatically send out a report. Or if there's a problem with the workflow, perhaps you want to notify someone so that they can fix the problem. Therefore, you can configure a set of email actions based on success only, failure only, and success or failure. Multiple email addresses separated by a comma or semicolon can be added to the dialog. The default job name is the workflow name plus execution time. However, you can change this to a custom name by entering the name in this box. Please note, if the workflow contains a BERT report, you can select the formats of the reports that are attached to the notification emails. The second tab allows you to save a report on the server. You can decide whether you always want to overwrite the report or whether to add a timestamp and save a new report for each workflow execution. You can also define where on the server you want to store your report and in what formats. If you click the OK button, a job is created and the workflow is executed right away. Another option is to schedule a job to be executed at a later time or on a regular basis. We'll now show you how to set this up in the next tab, Scheduling Options. Here you can see the options for setting the date and time of the execution. When executing the workflow just once, keep Schedule Job selected and choose the date and time you want the workflow to run. To schedule repeated or periodic workflow execution, select Repeat Execution. Once selected, you can choose between either executing the workflow in a fixed interval based on minutes, hours, or days, or to start execution at fixed start times. For both options, you can further restrict the executions by selecting the days of the week, days of a month, months, and the start times for when a job should be executed. So, for example, if you want to execute a workflow every hour between 9 a.m. and 10 p.m. on weekdays, you select Repeat Every Hour. By unchecking the checkbox Saturday and Sunday, the execution of the workflow is restricted to weekdays. In the Start Times tab, you can also restrict the time to have the workflow executed between 9 a.m. and 10 p.m. only. Another option is to define a fixed execution at 9 a.m. every morning, also taking daylight saving times into account. You select Repeat at Fixed Start Times and set the execution time in the Start Time tab. In addition, you have the option to skip the next execution if the previous execution is not yet complete, as well as to temporarily disable the schedule. Let's click OK and move on. Another option to execute a workflow is via the KNIME web portal. You can do this by either connecting to the web portal via a web browser directly, or by right-clicking a workflow and selecting Open in Web Portal. To trigger execution via REST from any other application, you can check out the possible request options by right-clicking and selecting Show API Definition. Another option is to execute the workflow via the Remote Workflow Editor by right-clicking a workflow and selecting Open as New Job on Server. That's all for today on executing workflows remotely on KNIME Server.